And at this time, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
We pray for our parish family of St. Charles. We pray so sincerely in longing for you, our parishioners, who normally we would be gathering with at our 10 masses here over the weekend, who are unable to come much as you would like to be here. We pray that even through this period of trial, we will be consoled by the Eucharistic Lord Jesus, who is never far from us if we open our hearts to him. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
And we pray for all the sick and suffering, especially those suffering from the coronavirus. We pray for all those suffering in our parish. Pray for the confirmed cases of the virus in our parish. We pray for the intention of this Mass, the repose of the soul on the cell of the cruce. We pray for all the faithful departed. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
And now in the silence of our hearts, let us bring our own prayers to our Heavenly Father. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Father in heaven, receive our prayers. Pour out your Spirit on us as you poured it out on David, the youngest son of Jesse. We make these prayers in Jesus' name. Amen. Blessed are you, Lord, God of all creation, for through your goodness we have received the bread we offer you, fruit of the earth and work of human hands. It will become for us the bread of life.
Blessed be God forever.
Blessed are you, Lord, God of all creation, for through your goodness we have received the wine we offer you, fruit of the vine and work of human hands. It will become our spiritual drink.
Blessed be God forever.
Pray now, brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice of your hands for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and the good of all his holy church.
We place before you with joy these offerings, which bring eternal remedy, O Lord, praying that we may both faithfully revere them and present them to you as is fitting for the salvation of all the world, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere, to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God. For you have given your children a sacred time for the renewing and purifying of their hearts, that freed from disordered affections, they may so deal with the things of this passing world as to hold rather to the things that eternally endure. And so with all the angels and saints we praise you, as without end we acclaim.
Sanctus, Sanctus.
Saints among the saints in the halls of heaven. with the Blessed Virgin Mary, the Mother of God, the Blessed Apostles, the Prophet David, St. Charles Borromeo, and all the saints, and with our deceased brothers and sisters, whom we humbly commend to your mercy. Then, freed at last from the wound of corruption, and made fully into a new creation, we shall sing to you with gladness the thanksgiving of Christ, who lives for all eternity. Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever.
Amen.
And now, brothers and sisters, taught by our Savior's command, informed by his divine teaching, we have the courage to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior Jesus Christ. For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity, in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
Brothers and sisters, the peace of the Lord Jesus be with you always.
And with your spirit. Let us offer each other the sign of peace.
Let us stand and pray. O God, who enlighten everyone who comes into this world, illuminate our hearts, we pray, with the splendor of your grace, that we may always ponder what is worthy and pleasing to your majesty, and love you in all sincerity, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Well, the only parish announcement, brothers and sisters, is stay tuned to this site or Facebook page, wherever you access this, and we will have the four priests of the parish saying Mass in our four languages, French, Spanish, English, and Brazilian Portuguese, next Sunday as well, and as many Sundays as necessary. I want to thank our musician with his great choir, Jim Pizzullo. I want to thank our very faithful deacon, Deacon Dave Rivera, and even though you didn't get to see him, our wonderful professional videographer, Father Abelardo Vasquez, who is the man behind the camera. And I want to encourage all St. Charles parishioners to check our website regularly during this period of crisis. That's www.stcharlesbridgeport.org. And we'll keep putting updates, and you'll also have a link to these masses there as well. I just have one final little remark, and Father Abelardo, I'm not sure if you can get a shot of that stained glass window in the corner, but in this church, which is dedicated to St. Charles Borromeo, the great 16th century Cardinal Archbishop of Milan. Not many know the story that he, who was so noted for his holiness in a time when not all bishops and priests were holy, became the spiritual mentor for the future St. Aloysius Gonzaga. And he actually gave Aloysius Gonzaga his first communion. I mention this story especially because Aloysius Gonzaga, as many of you know, though he was from a noble family, he grew up, entered the then still young Society of Jesus in Rome, and while ministering to the victims of the plague there, a much more serious epidemic, I have to say, than even what we're encountering now. And he ministered with much less ways of personally protecting himself than we have now. And as a young Jesuit in his 20s, he died from the plague. So as we celebrate Mass here, both those holy men of the 16th century are good reminders to us that conforming with all needed government and social and ecclesiastical requirements, we priests and we deacons and we Catholic ministers are here above all to serve, and to serve in a way that will endanger no one, but that will bring the love of Christ and the grace of Christ to all those in need. So let's pray for the grace and the wisdom to know how to do that during this challenging time. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
And may Almighty God bless you, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen. Amen. The Mass is ended. Let us go in peace, glorifying the Lord by
thanks be to God. And if by chance you want to come and see this beautiful window, it is at St. Charles Borromeo Church in Bridgeport, Connecticut, 1279 East Main Street, right in the heart of the beautiful east side of East Main Street. I think it's 1279.
1255.
Or 1255. Doesn't really matter. It's the only church on the line. Go in peace.
St. Michael,
the Archangel, defend us in battle. Be our protection against the wickedness and snares of the devil.
May God rebuke him, we humbly pray, and do thou, O Prince of the heavenly host, by the power of God, cast into hell Satan and all the evil spirits who prowl about the world, seeking the ruin of souls. Amen.
For he